Nearly 100 years ago, the father of cosmology took the first step towards understanding the nature of our universe. Just as a detective focuses his investigation on a certain group of suspects, so cosmologists study a particular set of universe types that should include us. Friedman, Lemaître, Robertson, Walker universes. Some of these universes are totally madhouses, while others are hard to tell apart from our own. That's why until a few years ago, we didn't know which universe we lived in. Real or not, I find them all fascinating. So I'm going to introduce you to 9 important universe types. When I get to the 9th, I'll tell you what experts believe our universe is like. But before we begin, we need to answer an important question. What makes these universes different? Well, a universe consists of things and the medium in which those things move, space-time. In fact, one of Einstein's greatest ideas was that space-time, rather than being a mere setting, is actually defined by its contents. So one universe differs from another depending on the things it contains. You might say that these universes are like a potato omelet. They can be made with just 3 ingredients, each of which has different effects on space-time. What are they? Let's start with matter. There are 2 types of matter. On the one hand, we have baryonic matter, which, to put it simply, is anything that contains protons and their relatives. I'm talking about galaxies, nebulae, planets, rubber duckies. On the other, there's dark matter, an invisible substance that's all around us, though we don't know its composition. Dark energy is something entirely different. It's the embodiment of Einstein's cosmological constant, a substance that expands the universe, making it bigger. There's not much more I can tell you about it. The nature of dark energy is one of the greatest mysteries in physics. The final ingredient is radiation. Here we find electromagnetic waves, neutrinos, and other particles that travel at close to the speed of light. Speedy stuff. I won't dwell on this because, spoiler alert, the density of radiation in our universe is very low. This is due to the fact that the universe's expansion stretches wavelengths, reducing radiation energy and making it less relevant than other substances. So, summing up, matter, radiation, and dark energy. Depending on how they're combined, we get one universe or another. Ready to get started? Here are the 9 types of universes that'll surprise you. The first is the empty universe, a universe that contains nothing, and yet it expands. And oddly enough, at a constant rate. I think of it as a reminder that space has its own entity. But let's liven things up. If I add a pinch of matter, I get number 2, the matter universe. Although space is still expanding, matter slows it down a bit until it reaches a stable velocity. But this doesn't happen if I add a lot of matter. In this case, expansion gets slower and slower until it eventually comes to a halt and contraction begins. That brings us to number 3. The collapsing universe, a universe with a predictable ending, a big crunch. This one has an interesting peculiarity. It can be circumnavigated. If you head out in one direction and continue in a straight line, you'll end up back where you started. However, if I add just the right amount of matter, I get number 4, the EINSTEIN-DE universe. Many people thought this was our type of universe. Since it has critical matter density, the geometry of this universe is the same one we learn at school, and the cosmic circumnavigation trick no longer works. If we emptied the universe of matter and filled it with dark energy, we'd have the contrived 5th universe. Cosmic tourism here is pure hell because, as the rate of expansion is constantly rising, the distances increase faster than you can ever cover them. We'll talk more about this another time. We can repeat the exercise, but fill the universe only with radiation, which would give us number 6, the light universe. This universe expands, but at an increasingly slower speed. It decelerates. Light fights to contract space. Aha, it's time for some mixology. Combine approximately 2 parts dark energy and 1 part matter, and we get number 7, the lagging universe. It looks quite calm, almost static, and suddenly one day, wham! It starts expanding at breakneck speed. There's not even time to say goodbye. Another cocktail, plenty of dark energy and a splash of matter. This is number 8, the rebounding universe. this universe doesn't have a Big Bang. It starts out very large and contracts until it stops and begins expanding again. A rebound. Time to head for home. Number 9, our universe. First of all, you need to know that what I'm about to say isn't some harebrained notion. It's based on the observations of thousands of scientists around the world who, for decades, have rigorously studied the oldest light in the universe and faraway objects. Remember when I told you that cosmologists have had to reactivate the cosmological constant? That's because it's everywhere. Our universe contains roughly 30% matter and 70% dark matter. Furthermore, of that 30%, 25% is dark matter. And of the remaining 5%, our instruments can only observe half. It's accepted that this 2.5% is dust that doesn't emit light. But even so, it's mind-boggling to realize that we only have a vague idea of what constitutes 95% of the universe, though physicists are working on it. Now, for a brief biography of our cosmos. In the past, there was a period when expansion slowed down, but for a long time now, the enormous amount of dark matter has been making it expand faster and faster. We live in a universe of accelerating expansion. It may not sound like a big deal, but believe me when I say that this will affect how we interact with the rest of the cosmos and what its fate will be. But I'll save that for another video. And remember, if you want more science, just hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.